In 1936, William Cook and John Mahon started a publishing company called Comics Magazine Company. The Comics Magazine No. 1 was dated May 1936 as their first release. Cook and Mahon were former employees of National Allied Publications, owned by Major Malcolm Wheeler Nicholson, the company that would soon become DC Comics. The duo published the premier issue of the Comics Magazine using inventory content from National Allied submissions. It's been suggested that it's possible this was in lieu of pay. All stories in issues number 1 and 2 are taken from DC's inventory. The series would feature a character named The Clock, who was the first masked hero in comic books. The title would last until 1940, ending with issue number 42. The Comics Magazine No. 1 would feature a character and two creators that go on to become quite famous. Mr. Mystic was created and done by Siegel and Shuster, the two who would go on to create Superman. This character is a Superman prototype. Mr. Mystic was not in a costume in this issue, but the weird thing was the character was later used in DC Comics More Fun No. 14 with the story The Koth and the Seven, continuing on from one publisher's book to the next. Another Siegel and Shuster character to appear in this title was Federal Agent, later renamed Federal Men when they also appeared in DC Comics. The Comics Magazine would change its name to Funny Pages with issue number 6. In number 1, we have a two-page story featuring Dr. Mystic. It's an adventure fantasy supernatural story featuring the characters Dr. Mystic, Zader, and Koth. Zader appears to attack the city, but only to attract Dr. Mystic's attention. He has come to bring Dr. Mystic through the spirit world to the Seven, but they are attacked by Koth on the way. Borrowed from More Fun Comics, the first installment of the Super Doctor occult storyline continues in More Fun Comics No. 14. When this number 1 comic hit the newsstands, it was the only series other than DC's More Fun and New Comics to have original content rather than strip reprints. But by all accounts, the material herein was originally intended for those two DC titles. That certainly explains the presence of work by Sheldon Mayer and Walt Kelly, as well as the cover art by Vin Sullivan. This new publisher only lasted about a year before being sold to the founders of Ultim Publications, who not long thereafter sold to Joe Hardy, who began Centaur Comics. The title turned into Funny Pages, which ended up eventually as a Centaur title. Number 1 also contains The Strange Adventures of Mr. Weed, a two-page story drawn and penciled by Sheldon Mayer, borrowed from New Comics. And J. Worthington Blip is also a two-page story by Sheldon Mayer, borrowed from New Comics. And there was a humor story, Cannonball Jones, drawn and written by Walt Kelly. Comics Magazine was the title only for issues number 1 and 2. The format of the early issues was 15-cent cover price, 68 pages, color cover and color interior, dimensions 7 1/4 by 10 1/2, paper cover with newsprint saddle stitched. The issue number 2 featured cover artwork by Sheldon Mayer. It also featured a 4-page story, Federal Agent, by Jerry Siegel and Joe Shuster, featuring the character Bart Regan, who would next be seen in Detective Comics No. 1 over at DC a year later. And Cannonball Jones came back for another 1-page story from writer-artist Walt Kelly. Issue No. 3, the title of the book officially changed to Funny Pages No. 3. Some of the standout features include The Sapphire Eye of Sekhmet, a 2-page comic story in the humor genre, and believed to be written by Will Eisner under the alias of Jack Seaman with pencils by Kenneth Earth. The next month we got number 4, and The Sapphire Eye of Sekhmet appeared once again, written by Will Eisner with pencils by Kenneth Ernst, an adventure story 2 pages long. Issue number 5 featured another story, which is believed to possibly be a Will Eisner story, but it's not noted official, so it's not confirmed. Pencils by Kenneth Ernst once again. Funny Pages number 6 was a key issue, featuring the first masked hero ever in the United States comic books. It was The Clock, in a story called This Clock Strikes, a 2-page story with story and art by George E. Brenner. An adventure story featuring The Clock, later to be known as Brian O'Brien. Slick Marden is the villain. And the storyline is about the clock successfully foiling a bank robbery. The story continues directly into Funny Pages number 7. The clock also appears in Funny Picture Stories number 1, which has the same cover date. The clock is a fictional masked crime fighter character created in 1936, the first masked hero to appear in American comic books. Created by cartoonist George Brenner, the clock first appeared in two Comics Magazine Company publications, Funny Pages number 6 and Funny Picture Stories number 1, both cover dated November 1936. His first appearances were in two-page features. The clock's secret identity was eventually disclosed as Brian O'Brien, a wealthy member of high society. The clock may be a missing link between pulp and comic book heroes. A hypnotist with a secret underground lair, his minimalist costume as a master of disguise was a three-piece suit and mask. The clock used a number of gadgets, including a cane whose head became a projectile and a diamond stud which fires tear gas, and customarily left a calling card with a clock face, and the clock has struck. Funny Pages number 7 came out the next month, features another clock story. A two-page story written and drawn by Georgie Brenner, the creator, adventure story featuring the clock and the villain Slick Marden and killer cats. With two-fisted gumption, the clock easily makes quick work of the bank robbers. Comics Magazine Company started a second title later in the year titled Funny Picture Stories. Number 1 came out with the clock on the cover, drawn by George Brenner. There was a clock story 7 pages long with story and art by George Brenner. The clock captures a night watchman who is in on a jewel heist. The clock also appears in Funny Pages Volume 1 Number 6, which has the same cover date. The clock's civilian name of Brian O'Brien is not given until the character's later run in feature funnies. George E. Brenner, born 1913, lived until 1952, an American cartoonist in the mid-1900s. He created comics such as The Clock, Bozo the Iron Man, and 7-Eleven. Brenner was first employed by the Comics Magazine Company before moving to Everett Busy Arnold's Quality Comics Group in late 1937, attaining the title of executive editor. He subsequently worked on titles such as Crack Comics, Dollman Quarterly, Feature Comics, Police Comics, and Smash Comics. The cover for Smash Comics 22 was even drafted by Brenner. One of the pseudonyms he used was Wayne Reed. Alan Burt Christman, known professionally as Burt Christman, was an American cartoonist. Christman and writer Gardner Fox are generally credited as co-creating the original Sandman, the Wesley Dodd version from DC Comics. While the character's first appearance is usually given as Adventure Comics number 40 in 1939, he also appeared in DC's 1939 New York's World Fair Comics Omnibus, which historians believe appeared on newsstands 1 to 2 weeks earlier. Each of the two story scripts were credited to the pseudonym Larry Dean. Fox wrote the untitled 10-page story New York World's Fair number 1, while he simply plotted, and Christman scripted the untitled 6-page story generally known as The Tarantula Strikes in Adventure number 40. Christman's plane was shot down and he was killed in 1942 while parachuting by the Japanese Army Air Force. This issue also featured Dick Kent, an 8-page story written and drawn by Arthur Pinnegan, an adventure story. What's interesting is that the last name is Kent, which would be the last name of Superman soon to come. Issue number 2 highlights featured a 7-page story of The Clock, written and drawn by George Brenner, and The Clock again, a sinister figure of mystery, and the police want to know his name. Comics Magazine Company started a third title at the very end of the year titled Detective Picture Stories. Number 1 came out with a 7-page story of Eddie Brannigan, written and drawn by George Brenner. The cover actually says it's a clock story, however, inside it's not. It's the story of Detective Brannigan tracking down Krauts, the Phantom Killer. By the end of the year, Comics Magazine Company would be the first to publish titles devoted to a single theme. They were Detective Picture Stories, Western Picture Stories, and Funny Picture Stories. Despite the title, Funny was about adventure-type stories. Detective Picture Stories would last 5 issues, and they would include some work by creators who would later become famous, like Will Eisner and Bob Kane. The title may have continued on with another name, but the specifics are not known. Funny Picture Stories lasted almost as long, but they did 3 volumes, resetting the numbers back to number 1 each time. The first went 9 issues, the second went 11 issues, number 6 being the first with the Centaur Comics name on it, and the third volume lasted 3 issues before the title gets renamed to Comic Pages from number 4 and up. The series also had work from people who later became famous, among them Charles Biro and Bob Wood, best known for Crime Does Not Pay, and Fred Gardner, who did a lot of work for DC Comics.